been. We are
Free Jazz All-Stars. These are all students at Freedom High School. This is an after-school program, and I'll tell you a little bit more about that later. There's a few announcements I need to make before we get started. First of all, if you have children that are playing in either ensemble, please have those children meet you in the lobby after the performance is over. And if you are recording this, please stop. I'm getting a master recording with all the mics, and I'll make sure and get copies for you that will like it. The next group that's going to be performing with us is my
director, Mr. Gary Wright, and the Hiwassee Dam Conga Club. Give them a good round of applause.
Jazz music and steel drum music is a little bit more laid back than
feel so formal using a mic. Our next selection is Four. It's more from the bop era of jazz. This is a Miles Davis tune. It'll be featuring Houston Cosby on trumpet and Nathan Dickens on trombone. Thank you. having a good time.
Thank you in Hawaii and Freedom High School Band Districts. our program, I have a couple things I want to say. First of all, there is no way in the world that I would be where I am right now if it wasn't for Gary Wright. He was not only a band director, but he's a mentor and a true friend to this day. I want to thank him. Also, I want to thank Wayne Justice for all of his help and all of his training and helping me to get where I am, trying to get better. The next group of people I want to thank are these people sitting right here. I've been teaching Freedom since my second year. I've been involved with the jazz program both semesters or both years, and I've had great students, but there's something just a little special about second semester, because first semester we have it as a class during the day, but second semester we aren't able to offer it as a class, so the students that are interested come after school. And I have some students, Graham Cornell, who's playing with us on electric bass and some upright bass. Graham came to me last semester and was really interested in jazz band, and he told me, "Mr. Higdon, I can't read music though. I play by ear, and my stomach felt like I drank battery acid when I heard that." But I really want to thank Graham, because he has come a tremendous way in his musicality. Now he's playing upright bass with us in our symphonic band. And to each and every one of these students, I've had some of these students in jazz band for both semesters ever since I've been here. And it takes a lot of dedication, folks, to get a student to come and spend 4 hours every week after school and practice their horn when they're not getting anything in return for it. They're not getting a grade. They're just here because they love music. And I just want to thank these kids sitting up here on the stage. These kids right here, it's what's right about music education. We hear so much today about education, about the bad things about it, but sometimes we need to step back and we need to look at the positive things and how hard some of our students work. I think we need to give every student on the stage a hand.
them from pre-K through 12. After a while, the choices for instrumentalists became kind of slim, as our school is a very poor school, designated as one of the poverty schools in North Carolina. So I made the decision to change the program over after I saw Appalachian State University do this and entertain. We're a little bit handicapped being on the stage. All you people, I'd like to reiterate, if you could come tomorrow night and support the Freedom Booster Club's fundraiser, where we can spread out and put the shells, we'll give you a show that's totally different from what you're seeing tonight, because we will, all you people like to dance, you'll get your opportunity, but I'm afraid I'll fall off the stage if I try to pull some of these stunts tonight. And during our 6 years of existence, my band's been to Hawaii twice on two 10-day tours. We played on the Big Red Boat last year, and we travel constantly. In our region of the state, music education is under severe attack. I guess all of you people involved in education know the new religion is called testing. Testing and adding requirements to the curriculum. Well, if you're in a big school like Freedom, it's a little easier to do that than in a small school where you only have 140 in grades 9 through 12. As we get squeezed there, we have to be more innovative. We basically started with about 5 sets of pens, and I apologize because this was not what I intended to show you tonight. The gentleman who makes our pens was supposed to make delivery yesterday, and this pen looked exactly double from what you see here on the stage. And that's made possible through the generous contributions of foundations of North Carolina. These kids, the man that you saw as Hammer, he was my assistant in Hawaii. He learned a lot about travel agent business real quick. That's Michael Hawkins. He's a good Michael. Always like to have my alumni back. I've got Brian Visconti, who plays rhythm section back here. He's an alumni of Tri-County. I have Tim Watson out in the audience, who was played pans with me for 5 years, right here. And again, I want to thank you for being invited. We're expecting the most major thing, hopefully, to happen within 12 days. I don't know if you've heard of the school Grammy competition, but this year over 50,000 school bands entered. And we will know in 10 days. We made the top cut. If we won the top 12 in the nation, then you'll probably get to see us on television here in about a month, hopefully. we're going to play now what they call traditional pan freestyle. This is not anything any other pan band does, so we never play the same piece twice. Again, I wish we were at a bigger place and we could get all you people involved in this. If you come tomorrow night, I promise. Thank you.
the swing chart. This is from the Benny Goodman Library. This is the biggest standard probably for clarinet and for swing that there's ever been. This is our rendition of Sing Sing Sing, featuring Tyrone Emmons on the drum set. Thank you. time before the jazz band's final selection to introduce some students that haven't been introduced yet in the jazz band. On first alto, we have Aaron Bland. Yeah. And we've had a new instrument added to us this semester. She's hiding behind the curtain. Carly Durgens is playing flute, vibraphone, and percussion. Debbie Gill is playing second alto. Christina Sparks, who is a freshman, coming up and really filling up the ranks, playing first tenor. Derek Cheeks playing second tenor. Derek Childress playing baritone saxophone. Jessica James playing second trombone. Travis Gibbs, third trombone. Josh Childress playing bass trombone. Katie Timmer playing piano. Rick Chain playing third trumpet. Rhett Price, who is another ninth grader, playing fourth trumpet. Also, Tyrone Emmons was on set. Graham Cornell. Graham, when I was talking about you earlier, you were hiding. Come out, Graham. That's my electric bass player, Graham Cornell. And Matt Barrett's also playing, he's been playing upright and electric for us. For a couple of rehearsals, my drum set player was sick and out, and we were playing along with this tune. And since he wasn't there, we had to improvise, and it was so close to rehearsal that I'm having to sit in. This last tune, I'm going to be playing drum set with him. It also features Aaron Bland on the alto sax, and Aaron has been in jazz band ever since I've been here. She's the only student in the band here that's been in jazz band for four semesters. And yesterday, I was having lunch at school when I was sitting there, and Aaron's father came up to me and said that she was sick the day before the gig. And I was like, well, we'll find something to do. And I was trying to make arrangements to get Davey to play first alto and everything, because she had a stomach virus and she wasn't going to be able to be here tonight. And we were arranging things around about halfway through the rehearsal after school yesterday. Erin comes walking in, and her face is pale green, and she looks very sick, and sits down and plays her horn and does a wonderful job. And I want to thank her for that, covering her part and being a very strong part of this jazz band program. This also features Katie Timmer on piano. And this piece is by one of my favorite composers. It's a very hard piece. This is grade 5 on the jazz list. And it's written by Victor Lopez, who actually was a band director, and now he's a high school principal in Miami, Florida. And he writes tunes all the time for his own jazz band, and I was fortunate enough 2 years ago to see